गुड मॉर्निंग, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर रितेश कुमार सारस्वत, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ईसी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एमएलबी टेक्सटाइल एंड इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज भीलवाड़ा। इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ प्रीवियस लेक्चर वेयर वी स्टडी अबाउट द बाइनरी फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग एंड द एम्पलीट्यूड शिफ्ट कीइंग एएसके, टुडे we will discuss about the binary frequency shift keying, that is the third one part of the digital modulation techniques. Here the expression and the waveform of binary phase shift keying is represent in the this one PPT, where the SH of T represent the higher frequency component, SL of T represent the lower frequency component. So first, starting the expression of the BPSK, firstly we have know about the basic definition or basic operation of BPSK, where the frequency shift keying is the digital modulation technique in which the frequency of carrier signal is changed as according with the modulating signal. It is just reflect that it is just similar to the frequency modulation in analog communication system, where is also the waveform carrier signal frequency is changed as according to the modulating signal. So similar way the approach is also applicable in BFSK, where the carrier signal is changed as a frequency of carrier signal is changed as according to the modulating signal. In binary FSK, individual data bits are used to control the frequency of carrier signal. During each bit interval, the modulator shifts the carrier to one of two possible frequency depending upon the value of the bit being modulated. That means that there are two bits, one or zero. Okay, so one is represent the higher one value and zero represent the lower one value. And the in case of NRZ representation, the one is represented by the plus one, okay, and the minus one represented by the zero, okay. So the one plus one is related to higher frequency component, where the frequency component will added with the carrier frequency, and for minus one or symbol zero, the particular frequency will be subtract from the carrier frequency. So as we see in equation number 6.51, as H of T that represent the H for high, that represent the higher frequency component, is related to the B of T equals to plus 1 or symbol 1 transmission, where omega naught is adding with the 2 pi fc component. And for symbol 0, that is related to the lower frequency component SL of T, that is equals to under root 2 P cos 2 pi FC minus omega naught into T, where the for symbol 0, the omega naught will be subtract in the carrier frequency FC, and the observable part is that amplitude in both cases, as seen in equation number 6.51 and the 6.52, amplitude, that is under root 2 pi, are same for symbol 1 and symbol 0. As seen in equation number 6.53, the symbol 1 is transmitted at the time carrier frequency will increase, that is equals to FH equals to FC plus omega naught divided by tau. And in case of symbol 0 is transmitted, the frequency component will be reduces, and that is represented by the FL, L for lower frequency component, that is equals to FC minus omega naught divided by 2 pi. And the waveform is represent for the different bit duration for bit sequence 10110100. Observation section and the observation view for the with respect to given bit sequence, the carrier frequency will change as according to the bit 1 and bit for bit 0. As seen waveform for bit 1, frequency component is higher, that is related to FH, and for bit 0, frequency component will be reduced, that is related to FL. So So first one bit, that is one, the frequency component or the carrier frequency will increases. For next bit is zero, the frequency component will be reduces and present the lower frequency component FL, which is related to equation number 6.55. Next PPT will represent the binary phase shift keying generation or the transmitter section. An arrangement is represented in figure. Input binary data sequence is applied to a level shifter 1 directly, while it is applied to level shifter 2 after passing through the inverter. Inverter convert 1 to 0 and 0 to 1 given bit sequence. The level shifter convert the 1 voltage level to under root P into TB. Okay, the 0 level remain unaffected. Thus the output of level shifter will be under root P TB if plus 1 or 0 if 0 bit is transmitted. Output of the level shifter are applied to product modulator. Another input to product modulator is frequency shifted carrier signal. Here in above part of this one figure, basically there are the two section. First one section is the level shifter 1 and another section is a modulator or multiplier, simply multiplier. So as seen this one figure, simply the binary input bit input data sequence is simply applied to the level shifter, okay, where the amplitude is under root P into TB, BH of T. BH of T may be 0 or 1. If 1, the output will be the under root P into TB, and if BH of T is 0, the output will be 0. Okay, that is given to a multiplier or a modulator, where the simply multiply the two terms, that is equals to first one is the under root P TB in BH of T, and the second one is the phi 1 of T. So both are multiplied, and the simply it is the where the phi 1 of T is the under root 2 upon TB 2 pi F H of T. F H of T the higher frequency component, that is related to phi 1 of T, is simply multiplied by the input bit sequence related to term under root P TB B H of T. So that's the the upper one part of the BFSK generator, and the lower one part is a consisting the inverter, level shifter and the product modulator. Inverter basically purpose convert the 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. So the input bit sequence will be inverted by using the inverter and provide the BL of T. Above one section is related to BH of T and the lower one section is related to BL of T. That is provide the lower frequency component. Okay. Given to the again similar way of level shifter and product modulator. Okay, so both are given to the product modulator. Okay, and the finally output of the product modulator, which is related to the phi 2 of T. Phi 2 of T basically related to FL of T. So the concluded part is that above one section is provided related to the FH of T, that is the higher frequency component, and the below one part is related to FL of T. Because as we consider in this one figure, we have to using a inverter that is responsible to convert the higher frequency component to lower frequency component. So the higher frequency component that is provided by the upper section and the lower frequency component that is provided by the lower section, both are added, and finally output is the binary phase shift keying signal. Next one PPT represent the binary phase shift keying detection part. As seen this one figure, there are the two section above one section is a combination of the product modulator and integrator, that is known as the correlator one, and the below one part is also a combination of the two section product modulator and the integrator, that's are known as the correlator two. Correlator 1 is tuned to carrier frequency corresponding to symbol 1, that is higher frequency component FH, while correlator 2 is tuned to carrier frequency corresponding to symbol 0, that is lower frequency component FL. Above one part correlator is related to higher frequency component as indicated in product modulator, where the cos 2 pi FHT. HT for high frequency component, whereas in lower one section that is represent the cos 2 pi FLT. So that is identifies that correlator 1 is related to higher frequency component FH of T, correlator 2 is related to the lower frequency component FL of T. Received binary FSK signal is applied to product modulator of both the correlator. Other input to the product modulator is carrier of frequency FH or FL. Output of modulator is applied to subsequent integrator. While integrate the signal over a bit interval, the output of integrator 1, that is related to correlator 1, is L1, while the output of integrator 2 related to correlator 2 is represented by the L2, and the L1 and L2 are applied or feed to the decision making device. The decision making device compare both the output L1 and L2. If the output L1 is greater than L2, then decision making device a decision in favor of symbol 1. Okay. And when the L1 is less than L2, then decision making device will decision making device in favor of symbol 0. Thus, based on decisioning binary data sequence is obtained at the output of the decision making device. Basically, there are the two comparable part L1 and L2. And when the L1 is greater than L2, that means the above correlator, which is related to FH of T, is more dominant as compared to lower one section. So FH of T is dominant, that means it is related to symbol 1. And when second case is that if L1 is less than L2, that means L2 is more dominant, that means the FL is more dominant as compared to FH of T, so it will provide the symbol 0. So finally, output of a decision device will provide a sequence of 0 or 1, that is the binary input bit sequence which are using is in the transmitter section or a binary phase shift keying generator. Thank you.